being a student of Rishi Valley, Krishnamurti struck me at a very young age. And ever since I've started reading Krishnamurti, I was inspired by the teachings. And whatever I did later on in life was something related to the teachings. And now I'm doing something in relation to dance and music. And I feel that dance is one way by which the human emotion can be expressed to its maximum extent. And I felt that traditional music and dance, though it's such a beautiful medium of expression, has always been dwelling with traditional mythology about Rama, Krishna, and poetry, which are very traditional. And somehow people had lost the connect with these traditional dances, which were really beautiful and still really beautiful. So I thought, why can't somebody with this great philosophy, which is useful to day-to-day life, why can't we, through dance, bring this about so that, like how it inspired us, why can't we share this inspiration with as many people as possible?
The stage version, I give dance the precedence. Stage is essentially a performer's medium. So I wanted everything there was to say, the deep philosophical input, to come through dance. In the DVD version, I had a slightly more intimate approach, where I wrote it like a Guru Shishya dialogue. And here the anchor becomes then the Shishya, asking and investigating and receiving answers in the form of dance. But in both productions, I make sure the audience is always kept involved, and the audience does not receive direct answers but gets questions and inputs to further their own inquiry. This is totally in keeping with Jiddu Krishnamurti's teaching, who always emphasized self-inquiry and never imposed. The dancers interpreted their texts their own way and choreographed accordingly. The musicians set tunes to the lines in the way they saw fit. So in that way, both of us, all of us actually, as creative people involved in the project, were actually discovering for ourselves and creating and interpreting all at the same time. So I would say Essence of Life is very empowering, because it tells you that change is in your own hands. So when you start with yourself, you will see this reflected into the outer world, and perhaps there is a much more beautiful world out there to create. The possibilities are limitless. This is not an utopian ideal, it's not a fairy tale, but it can be reality if we begin to work on it.
I have composed music for a lot of thematic albums, but this one was a great challenge for me. It was not so easy to produce the music for JK's philosophy, blending with 5 different dance forms. I tried my level best to convey his thoughts through my music. I have used a maximum live instruments, which gave life to the compositions. I am really blessed to work with the singers like Dr. M. Balamurli Krishnaji and Padma Shri Hariharanji and Sanjeev Abhyankarji, who has given their best in this project, and they are the one who has conveyed the essence of JK's teachings.
When the composer of this ballet, Mr. Sivarama Krishna Rao, approached me to compose the rhythm part of this project, I was a little bit hesitant, because previously I composed rhythm for devotion and bhakti. Whereas in this project, content is philosophy, which is a very, very unique thing for dance. The dance forms are 5. I have to use those authentic instruments predominantly, and for expressing the other moods, I have borrowed the other instruments like pakhavaj, tabla, idakkai, suddhamathalam, it's a sort of challenge for me. In other dance ballets, it is just like composing mathematical permutation combinations for dance. Whereas here I have to embellish the meaning of the sentence.
It is the first time that I'm working with, five forms of dance in the same music piece. The compositions are very complex, and I must say that it's really inspiring and very, very challenging working on such a composition, both as a sound designer and both as an audio engineer. But really is something about the way the compositions are built here and the way it needs to interact with the dance. It gives a whole new perspective of work. It's out of the box, but in the box, and it's a great honor to work on a project like that.
High level of philosophy of Vidu Krishnamurti required an equally high level of music and dance. So from my side, I said, let's put in the visual content in as beautiful format as possible. The music had already been composed and the dancers had been approached from all over the world. I could visualize how this dance had to be from listening to the music. When we went to Coorg, we were absolutely amazed because it was nature in all its pristine beauty. Just water bodies all around, with little pieces of land, birds flying, calm, tranquil, exactly like the theme of essence of life. So we said, this is it.
मनस्तु मुक्तं भवति.
It was very difficult to express his teaching through dance because it was depth, and I thought just by making into a abhinaya by word doesn't convey the real essence or a real meaning of it. So I had to think and try.
Manastu sarvada saghosham avishrantam. Manastu sarvada saghosham avishrantam kimartham sarvada.
In terms of idiom, I've always felt that Bharatanatyam has the scope to portray pretty much every emotion, every feeling, every philosophy. But in particular, when I started the choreography, I did realize that I had to push boundaries and I had to do something new. And something new, at the same time, something that's not divorced from what Bharatanatyam allows. So it's been a tricky tightrope walk.
Because I'd heard a lot about him, and it was the first time that an opportunity had come to me to explore and do a dance piece reflecting his thoughts. So, and I thought, you know, this is a lovely opportunity, and since it leads to growth, this would help me explore the horizons of dance to a greater extent. And also it would help me, you know, try out a different kind of theme, because the bedrock of Indian classical dances usually lies in the mythological stories. But this was something out of the box, and I like experimenting with themes like this.
Great teacher. It was a bit difficult to choreograph some part of it, because to reach, to convey the message to even laymen, I thought it should not be too classical oriented, but I never wanted to deviate from the fundamentals.
Where is the time to think about silence and meditation? And when I was given the topics, it just made me realize that it's high time I look for that solidified silence that we're all perhaps seeking for. And it doesn't take long to attain that, simply because it's simple. The only word that comes to me when his philosophy is concerned, or his teachings, or his thoughts are concerned, is simplicity. And that's what kept me going.
सत्य धर्म मनसा एव द्रष्टुं शक्या पवित्रता।